Okay, this reading is for Pisces. This is the Love Lies series. Pisces, what are their secrets in their relationships? Pisces. All right, the first card that came out is the Six of Swords, you guys. Someone may be wanting to move forward and not accept an offer. Or this could be you, Pisces, okay? You may not want to accept an offer. Could be with a home situation. Could be dealing with a Leo. Or this Leo doesn't want to accept this situation from you. I believe that it may just be you who doesn't want to, who don't want to accept this relationship. With the Three of Swords, this person could have left you heartbroken. You guys could have had found out about a lot of secrets in the past. If my cards start flying everywhere. You may be dealing with an Aries. Something is saying to look forward. I think you have, I don't know, it's maybe a feeling about something to move forward. Yeah, you definitely don't want to go back to your past. If this is something that you're not communicating, once the truth come out, it's going to be a lot of conflict, okay? You may be dealing with a fire sign, Leo's Aries Sag, but that communication is going to come in fast. Let's find out about what? That you're in your two minds, or someone is in two minds about really going through with this offer. It could be an Aries again. Again, you have the fire sign, Leo's Aries Sag, King of Wands, and Queen of Wands in reverse. So there's no passion in this relationship. Your person can really be an asshole. If this is a female, he can really be an asshole. Sometimes fire signs are that way. But if this is an Aries, definitely a Leo, who I see Aries and Leo a lot. They could be so egotistical, and it's just a turn off for you. All right, which direction you want to go towards, you're not really sure yet, but you do know this isn't bringing you fulfillment, okay? All right, you may be looking towards a new relationship, something that's giving you, whether it's giving and receiving. And I know Pisces, you could be in your head about that. You may have two people that you're dealing with. You may have two people that you're dealing with. Okay, but right now I think you're holding back on your feelings. I think you're holding back on offering love, as a matter of fact. You could have found out this person was being sneaky and deceptive. Lies and everything. And again, like I said, you could be holding back your feelings. Okay. If anything, this person is offering sex. If they are offering, in this relationship, if it's with another water sign, this can just be the energy of your partner. It's just sex. Right now, it's just giving sex. I want to say that you may have a new offer coming in from another water sign, because sex could have just been what the previous relationship has been based on, okay? All right, yeah. When it comes to the commitment, not really happening. You could be dealing with a Libra or a Taurus, but there's no healing in this situation. Someone keeps looking at another direction. I don't know, maybe it's you who's looking in a different direction, or your person, but that's the truth that's coming out. If you guys are dealing with an Aquarius, they are absolutely looking somewhere else, okay? This person is sneaky, and he is just not in the best energy. He could be not vibrating high. Very well could be offering love offers to other people. It could be a third party situation, especially if you're dealing with a Libra. This person is not giving or taking much. Not at all. Yeah. He or she or you could be focused on your money. Or here's an earth sign that's coming up in this reading, where you may have a new start with money, or you may have a new start with passion with an earth sign, Capricorn, Taurus, or Virgo. Okay, it's happened quickly. Well, now, looking at that, wait a minute. You guys could be dealing with this earth sign already, and that could be the secret. Yeah, sex and abundance. You may be happy with this. This person may take away your stress and your burden. If it was a third-party situation, I think you're actually deciding to choose one, come out your head with it, coming out of your head, out of your mind with it, and trying to find some type of victory. One of you guys could be stalking, definitely trying to see what the other person is doing, trying to keep up with them. But overall, you guys are waiting. Just waiting to see which way should you offer this cup. Because I think some days you're happy and then other days you aren't. Okay? It could definitely be a Capricorn, but if it is a Capricorn, I don't think you're happy in that situation. Like, you're just like there. You don't even care if you stay there or not, or if that person leaves or not. Like, you're not guarded. You're like, do whatever you want. The attitude is nonchalant. Like, do whatever it is that you want, okay? If it's a Scorpio that you're dealing with, Pisces, you could be dealing with a Scorpio, but I really just don't. I'm not sensing any change in the situation with the Capricorn. And I think you're pretty much like over it. It's whatever, all right? Let's clarify a little bit more. This is the storytelling deck. You guys, don't forget, you can book with me if you like. If you like. All right. Again, here we go. Wheel of Fortune, sideways. You guys don't know which way to go. I think you need to get out of your mind and stop being indecisive, okay? If it is a Virgo, Capricorn, or Taurus, there's going to be a tower moment or something that you find out about this person or a situation that they could be in that leaves you guarded to this situation. And that could very well be the reason why you're looking in two directions, okay? This person could have had a partner already. Water, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. I see Leo, and it's a part of their past. That situation wasn't very abundant. It wasn't a happy home. I don't see a new beginning starting with that person's past. So if that is a thought or something that's in your head, you can leave it. You know, remove it. It's not happening. This person isn't dealing with that person. And if they have children, that's the only reason. Here we go with the Leo card again. If you're dealing with the Leo and you have a child by this Leo, this person isn't giving much. It's like breadcrumbing. You get what I'm saying? But I think this person absolutely, whoever's in your past, whoever, Pisces, male or female, is in your past, this person is absolutely refusing to move forward, even with you breadcrumbing them. So see, that situation is pretty much dead in the past. There's no commitment there. You get what I'm saying? You're not really offering anything. I think you're coming out of your head about it. It could have been some betrayal in the past, but I don't think you think the past is no longer an option. That's what I'm looking at. You're not working on it anymore. All right. If you're dealing with a Virgo, I think this person's truth is you may have been betrayed by this Virgo before. They weren't very loving. Probably a little bit blunt. Yeah, a little mean. That's what it looked like. But they're healing. They're trying to heal. Something about them, and that's probably what they're communicating to you, that they're trying to heal. I think this person is trying their absolute damnest, their hardest to offer you something, but they're holding back because they're not sure if it's going to be any victory in it, but I damn sure believe that they want victory in it. That's the thing, okay? They're in two minds about the entire situation. Yes, they are. But this iffiness could put you in a mindset that's just like, I'm not giving shit. If you're dealing with the air sign, Libra, Gemini, Aquarius, this person wants to offer you love, want to, just isn't sure if they should. And I mean, it's as simple as that. Three of Swords in the reverse. It's not like they're heartbroken. You guys could have went through things in the past, but if they may have had a thought about moving forward, but it seems like they always come back. Like, they don't ever leave. They always come back. And for referrals, but the secret is, this is the Moon card, which is us, or Cancer, and I see Cancer here. If you bring dealing with a Cancer, if a new Cancer is coming in, understand that person loves you. It's not going to be anything bad, okay? That should be a good situation. But going back to that King of Swords, if the secret is, this person doesn't want to move forward from you. And they just don't want to experience heartbreak from you, okay? Or vice versa. Whoever this air sign is, it really seems as if, yeah, they love you. It seems as if they love you. But they're always in their minds about offering this cup. Always. Always. It doesn't matter what you say or do. See? Here we go. Offering this cup. You guys, I wish you could have seen how all of my cards just flu everywhere. I'm not gonna let them do that to me today. Okay, so we're gonna keep going. When my cards fall, it's because it's getting the story right. I have to pick them up a certain way. That's it. Although love is being offered, I don't think something practical is. And that's probably keeping you in your head. And you're not communicating about your true feelings. Open your mouth, Pisces. Open your mouth. See, you're not communicating about how you truly feel. It's time to talk. If you're scared of this person, you shouldn't be with this person, okay? Talk about how what you want in the future with this person. Talk about the family, the stability, and everything you want. I seen the Queen of Pentacles. You absolutely could be dealing with a Virgo, Capricorn, or Taurus. You need to open your mouth and communicate honestly about how you're feeling. Because if you don't, you know what I mean? What is that person supposed to do? How do you expect them to react? If they don't know the truth from you, right? All right, I'm gonna try to end this short. Cut this short. Sometimes you guys, when I'm shuffling, these messages are coming through. Anything come out of my mouth. Excuse my language if I swear too much or if I sound angry. I'm just trying to get the messages to you guys, okay? Right now you're guarded. Definitely guarded. Again, with the communication, I believe that you need clarity on where you want this to go. If this is gonna be a situation for you guys or if it isn't. I don't believe this person want you to be single. That's the thing. They may want marriage with you. If it's a Libra Taurus, they may want marriage with you and build with you and build with you. Yeah, and heal and get you out of taking a break. You could be dealing with a Scorpio, but something, yeah, you definitely could be dealing with a Scorpio male, someone. But something about this situation, the person is just really waiting for you to confidently tell them what you want. Just say it. Just say it. Don't be scared about rejection. Rejection is God's protection. So if it doesn't work out, oh fucking well. Next case. That's all I hear. This person could be coming in with an offer of sex. Someone could be coming in with an offer of sex. A very immature fire sign is what I'm seeing. This person could very well be an Aries. There's something about this Aries in a reverse that this person is just very immature. And I don't think you want to go through with the commitment with this person. You guys may be showing that you're happy, but behind closed doors, it's not given. And that, yeah, it's toxic. Or you could be leaving a Capricorn, but that, whoever that Aries is, you don't want that. You know what I mean? This person may be juggling, offering anything to everyone. Could be a Libra who's doing the same thing, but let's just see. Truth coming out about a Libra. He could be for the streets, he or she. Could be looking in a different direction and just not telling you anything. No, they're not. They're actually confused on what the hell they want. Libras are very indecisive. You can only take what they say with a grain of salt. Watch everything that they do, okay? They don't want to move on. But I think your ass is going to walk away, Pisces. You're going to get tired of this indecisiveness. You can't take it. Yeah, that person may be feeling left out in the cold once you make your decision. And feeling regretful. They may have missed the opportunity with you, okay? Definitely may have missed the opportunity. Is there anything else you want me to tell my Pisces? If there is a third party situation, you haven't found out yet, but I'm here to tell you there may be a third party situation with a Leo. Something about a Leo. This guy is in the reverse. I don't think he's from your past. But you could be, that could be a sneaky link, a Leo. Lord, Pisces and Leos. If no one knows, I knew, okay? Yeah, sneaky link that may lead you to feeling out in a cold, being betrayed, okay? I think in the beginning, it's, and that's the clarity on that. It could have started off great, but honestly, it's probably some bullshit. This person is juggling. Maybe wanting to go back to his past. You know what I mean? Maybe want to go back to his past. He probably ran back to his past. And shit like that just turns Pisces off. If you ever want to fucking ruin a relationship with a Pisces, bitch out on him, okay? I don't know if you're working on a situation. You may be trying to, but yeah, and trying to manifest something of it. But you know what I mean? Not really seeing happiness with the Leo, okay? So you can wait if you want. It won't happen. He or she or you could be stalking. Definitely. I think you both are stalking each other. Definitely. There's no balance in this situation. If you're dealing with a Sagittarius. It could be secrets about this Leo baby mother or feelings. But I don't feel like they're offering that person anything. I don't really see an offer. I really believe this Leo could be fucking around with other people. And once you find out about the truth, you'll be fine. You'll be fine. I don't think you necessarily want to be single or walk away, but that may be the advice. Gosh. This Libra wants balance in this situation, okay? He wants whatever home life you guys used to have to come back and be back to normal. Libras always fuck up. If there's a sign that fucks up all the time, it's a Libra and definitely a Leo. All right? So, Pisces, that's it.